When it comes to bad habits and the harp, I think that this habit is one of the hardest to eliminate. Without a teacher, it can be really hard to notice that you're doing it in the first place, and even if you know you need to watch out for it, it can sneak back unnoticed when your attention is elsewhere. My name is Zuzanna, I'm a harpist and a harp teacher, and in today's episode of the Coffee Break Harp, I'm going to talk about sliding. What is it? When it can happen? Why it's such an unhelpful habit? And most importantly, how to prevent it from happening. So what is sliding and what does it look like? Sliding can happen when you're placing, and as the name suggests, your fingers slide along the string before you play. The most common type is downward sliding, when you arrive on a string and once your finger is on, you let it slide further down. This often comes together with the fingers pointing upwards instead of downwards before you place. The slightly less common is the type of sliding where you arrive on strings and make your fingers slide up. Usually this is when you notice your thumb is not quite high enough and you make a last minute effort to put it higher. Sliding can have quite a few negative consequences for your playing. First, any kind of slide takes extra time, and even though it may seem that it takes just a split of second, when it becomes a habit that you need to perform every time you place fingers on the strings, this time adds up and it may prevent you from playing your pieces up to speed. Reason number two, it not only takes more time, but also requires extra effort. With all the things that you're already doing at the harp, you really don't want any extra tasks to perform, but instead take the most direct route possible. 3. Sliding can jeopardize your hand position. It often comes in pair with fingers pointing up instead of down, or insufficient space between the thumb and other fingers. 4. In addition to hand position, it can also affect your position on the strings. So you may be aiming to place your fingers right in the middle of the strings, but after you slide, you may end up much further away than you wanted to. This does affect your sound, as the tone is very different depending whether you play here or down here on the harp. 5. Sliding can cause buzzing, especially when it comes together with fingers pointing up. Now, buzzing is a whole other big topic on its own, but sadly, sliding is one of the contributing factors when it comes to buzzing. The most annoying thing about sliding is that it can be really hard to notice. Buzzes are pretty obvious and much harder to ignore as you can hear them, but sliding usually doesn't make any sound. The other thing that makes sliding really difficult to notice is that, as opposed to other unhelpful habits, it usually happens before we even play anything. And as much as in our practice we strive to be alert and mindful about what we hear once we start hearing the sound of the harp, it's often the case that our attention isn't quite there yet before we make that first sound. Because of that, sliding is something that can stay hidden for quite a long time, and once we get used to doing it, we find it really, really hard to notice. Even when we look at our hands really closely, at this point we may get so used to seeing them behave in a certain way that we can't tell whether we're doing anything wrong. Sometimes it can get to the point where you have to work with a teacher for a prolonged period of time to just start noticing what's happening. In a sense, to train your eyes to spot this unhelpful habit before you can actually train your fingers. Sometimes sliding can sneak in when you're trying to practice raising your arm after playing, or when you try to use these gestures to keep your hand relaxed. When you move your hands further away from the strings and then try to come back, sometimes the fingers try to give themselves some extra assurance when landing, and that's when sliding can happen. Also, when you try to relax your hands by performing additional movements with your arm, your fingers may find it more difficult to stay in control. By the way, if you want to learn more about raising your arms after playing and other gestures, as well as their relationship to relaxing hands, make sure to check one of my previous episodes where I was talking more about this topic. All in all, once you get into the habit of sliding, it can be really, really hard to stop doing it. So it's really important that you make sure your fingers don't fall into this trap and you stay in control of what they're doing. How to tell if you're sliding? If you suspect you may be doing it but aren't quite sure, a teacher can tell you whether that's the case. They can also support you in overcoming this habit, which can be a rather challenging process. What you really need is having someone pointing it out to you before you play anything, and at any point when you may be so focused on the notes, fingering, or anything else which means you cannot pay the attention to what the fingers are doing. If you haven't got a teacher, try recording yourself and playing the video back, maybe in slow motion. I encourage you to consider sharing it with other harpists and asking for their feedback. As mentioned before, if it's a habit that has been with you for a while, you will likely be sliding literally every time you play a note, and this in turn may likely mean that you have never seen your fingers doing anything different, and you just won't be able to tell the difference. So if you can, definitely consider asking someone for help. Okay, now, but what can you do to prevent sliding? As I said before, this habit is one that very often will require support of a teacher, so definitely consider asking for help. When you work on your own, you need to pay lots of attention to the moment when this habit is actually happening, which is before you play. And the best way to make sure you really pay attention and not get distracted by playing that comes after is to practice only placing, without playing. So take the very first chord of your piece, or even a single note, whichever comes first, and then place your fingers on the strings. Stop, go away, do it again. Place, take off, do it again. And while doing this, you will definitely find it helpful to think about your hand position way before your hand has landed on the strings and get ready in advance. One way to do this is to gently close the fingers into the palm of your hand, without clutching, and approach the strings like that. Aim for the point in the middle of the strings, where you want to be, get your hand closer, and at that point you can let your fingers open, land on the string, and stay there. One of my teachers shared an excellent way to think about placing that can help you a lot if you're working on confident placing and want to prevent sliding. Imagine your hand is an airplane and your fingers are the wheels. So when you're up in the air, your wheels are inside the belly of the plane, but they need to come out before you land. They need to be facing the air, which is exactly what we do at the harp. They need to be ready before, but we can't have them go up high, as that means that the whole plane is likely going up in the air again. So when you're at the harp, make sure that your wheels are ready, meaning the position of your hand is as close as possible to what it needs to be once on the strings. And even if you don't really go anywhere but stay connected on the strings, you can still keep thinking about that. So let's say you're going to use your three fingers to play. Right after your fingers have closed and touched the palm, you let them bounce off like a ball and open again, but stay low. That's how they can stay, so when you need to play them again, you just bring them a little closer to the strings and you're ready to play again. Even though airplanes don't really do that, it works for us, harpists. Now let me know in the comments, have you heard about sliding before? Do you suspect your fingers may be doing this without you realizing? And if so, which of these tips you will try first? I'll be looking forward to hearing from you and to seeing you here very soon. Make sure you subscribe so you'll be among the first to hear when the new episode is out. In the meantime, take care, I'll see you soon. Bye!